Someone, anyone, please help my wife.
What's wrong with your wife?
She gets sick when the weather's foul. Can't catch her breath, like cobwebs in her lungs. Our son Hindle makes a potion that lets her breathe. He's the only one who can make it, but he's joined that cult in the hills. Please, get to him and tell him what's wrong. Without that potion, she'll die.
Around to kill you for poaching. Too dangerous to go hunting now. More likely to find mages than luck.
Good luck.
Luck won't go fat.
What do you need to keep these refugees warm?
Blankets, warm clothes, all of it. These poor sods lost everything when the mages and the Templars went crazy. If we were in a village, I could just pinch a blanket off a clothesline and be fine. Out here, I'm sure the apostates have plenty of supplies, just haven't been able to find them.
Farewell.
And see you.
Mages and Templars don't seem to care who gets caught in their war. The refugees here are in dire need of help. If the war doesn't kill them, cold or starvation will.
What can you tell me about the man who's supposed to be getting horses for the Inquisition?
Horsemaster Dennett. He lives on a farm to the west. Tough old fella. We haven't heard from him. Best we can tell, he's holed up until the Mages and Templars are done killing each other.
What other problems do these refugees face?
We've got some injuries that go beyond stitches and elf fruit. I know healers are in short supply, but if you can find someone in Redcliffe to help us, it would save a lot of lives.
You were concerned about refugees starving?
Yes. Many of them brought food, but they expected to be home by now, or safe in a city. There's a hunter up the hill who has some idea.
Is there anything we can do to help people deal with the cold?
I asked the Inquisition to send blankets. You'd think I was asking for a wagon of raw lyrium. A recruit named Whittle is trying to make what we can bring in last. If you have any ideas, talk to him across the road.
Farewell.
And you as well.
Decent spot to camp.
Nothing to report, sir.
Look at this. The apostates have gone mad with power.
The Templars aren't looking any better here.
Continue on if we are to secure the Alliance.
Come on.
By the end of Hardin Hightown, almost every character is revealed as a spy or a traitor.
Wait, you read my book?
It was in the Inquisition Library. Everyone but Donnan turned out to be in disguise. Is that common?
Are we still talking about books, or are you asking if everyone I know is a secret agent?
Are there many tricksters in Dwarven literature?
A handful, but they're the exception. Mostly they're just honoring the ancestors. There you go, stuff. Human literature. Now there's where you'll find the tricky, clever, really deceitful.
Curious.
Not really. Dwarves write how they want things to be. Humans write to figure out how things are.
This must be Master Dennett.
There must be something here.
So you're the Inquisition, eh? Watch yourself, Inquisition. It's ugly out there. Name's Dennett. I served Arleman for 30 years as horsemaster. I hear your Inquisition is looking for mounts.
It is. Can you help us?
Not at the moment. I can't just send 100 of the finest horses in Ferelden down the road like you send a letter. Every bandit between here and Haven would be on them like flies on crap. You'll have mounts once I know they won't end up as a cold winter's breakfast.
If you have a problem with me personally, I'd like to know about it.
What? Just because I called you a mule rider? Maker. Any beast that can haul a wagon of lyrium through the mountains and not go mad is damned impressive. My wife Elena manages the farms, and Bron's in charge of my guards. They'll tell you what they need. Until then, you deserve something better than whatever knock-kneed plowneck they gave you. The chestnut over there is a purebred Ferelden Forder. Take care of him, and he'll take care of you, Inquisition.
Master doesn't want me handing those refugees weapons until they've got any hope of defending themselves. If you put up a few watchtowers, we'd all have more warning before the next attack.
You said you had a way to help the refugees.
I do. There are too many hills in these parts, good places for raiders and bandits to gather. I've marked good spots on the map. You set up watchtowers there, I'll talk to the Master and get your people weapons.
Farewell.
I heard what my man said. If you want our horses, then we need our farmers back safe in their fields. Since the breach appeared, the wolves have gone mad. They come after our men like beasts with the water sickness. You deal with the wolves, and our farmers will be safe again.
How are these wolves acting differently from normal?
Normal wolves go after livestock, but come at them with a torch and a blade and they run. These beasts, though, it's like Darkspawn during the Blight, or when the dead rose to attack us. They're possessed, or something like it. I've lost too many men to the beasts. I won't endanger more.
Farewell.
Good day to you.
Elena was right. Something has driven these animals mad.
The breach may have driven them mad. Or perhaps a demon took command of the pack.
The apostates have fled to the hills.
Redcliffe has seen more than its share of troubles. That the rebellion should play out here. The Templars have secured a position ahead. refugees should be safer on the King's Road now.
We must still deal with the apostates, however.
Your kind killed the most holy.
Lies. Your kind let her die.
Shut your mouth, mage!
Enough!
Knight Captain.
That is not my title. We are not Templars any longer. We are all part of the Inquisition.
And what does that mean exactly?
Back already, Chancellor. Haven't you done enough?
I'm curious, Commander, as to how your Inquisition and its herald will restore order as you've promised.
Of course you are. Back to your duties, all of you.
Mages and Templars were already at war. Now they're blaming each other for the Divine's death.
Which is why we require a proper authority to guide them back to order.
Who? You? Random clerics who weren't important enough to be at the Conclave.
The Rebel Inquisition and its so-called Herald of Andraste? I think not.
I don't believe I'm Andraste's herald any more than you do, Chancellor.
That laudable humility won't stop the Inquisition from using the misconception when it suits them.
The Inquisition claims only that we must close the breach or perish.
You say that now, Commander. We shall see if the sentiment remains true.
The mages and Templars are fighting, even though we don't know what really happened at the Temple of Sacred Ashes?
Exactly why all this should be left to a new divine. If you are innocent, the Chantry will establish it as so.
Or we'll be happy to use someone as a scapegoat.
You think nobody cares about the truth? We all grieve Justinia's loss.
But you won't grieve if the Herald of Andraste is conveniently swept under a carpet.
How widespread is the violence between mages and Templars?
Impossible to say.
Your organization flouting the Chantry's authority will not help matters.
With the Conclave destroyed, I imagine the war between mages and Templars is renewed with interest.
Remind me why you're allowing the Chancellor to stay?
Clearly, your Templar knows where to draw the line.
He's toothless. There's no point turning him into a martyr simply because he runs at the mouth. The Chancellor's a good indicator of what to expect in Val Royeau, however.
Well, let's hope we find solutions, and not a cathedral full of Chancellors.
The stuff of nightmares.
Mark, if you will. I'm certain the Maker is less amused.
Dispels the darkness upon us. Caryadon will have more poultices for the injured as soon as possible, revered mother.
Thank you, child. You are doing all this work.
Have you been able to save many people?
More than if we had not tried.
The Inquisition cannot remain a prison if you can't prove it was founded on Justinia's orders.
This is an inopportune time, Marquis. More of the faithful flock here each day. But allow me to introduce you to the brave soul who risked his life to slow the magic of the breach. Master Kadash, this is the Marquis Durellion, one of Divine Justinia's greatest supporters.
And the rightful owner of Haven. House Durellion lent Justinia these lands for pilgrimage. This Inquisition is not a beneficiary of this arrangement.
This is the first I've heard of Haven having an owner outside the Chantry.
My wife, Lady Machin of Denerim, has claim to Haven by ancient treaty with the monarchs of Ferelden. We were honored to lend its use to Divine Justinia. She was... a woman of supreme merit. I will not let an upstart order remain on her holy grounds.
Demons are pouring from the sky, and you're worried about land claims.
Haven is the Durellion's rightful property.
Has Empress Selene officially acknowledged your possession of Haven? I was unaware Her Imperial Majesty had conferred with the Queen of Ferelden on this matter.
The Empress has not yet had the opportunity to do so.
We face a dark time, Your Grace. Divine Justinia would not want her passing to divide us. She would, in fact, trust us to forge new alliances to the benefit of all, no matter how strange they might seem.
I'll think on it, Lady Montpellier. The Inquisition might stay in the meanwhile.
Do the Durellions actually have a claim on this place?
His Grace's position is not so strong as he presents it. Despite their Ferelden relations, the Durellions are Orlesian. If the Marquis wishes to claim Haven, Empress Selene must negotiate with the Ferelden on his behalf. Her current concerns are a bit larger than minor property disputes.
I'm so pleased the Marquis isn't tossing us out into the cold.
His Grace is only the first of many dignitaries we must contend with.
You expect more people in Haven?
Undoubtedly. And each visitor will spread the story of the Inquisition after they depart. An ambassador should ensure the tale is as complimentary as possible.
What sort of dealings have you had with nobility?
For some years, I was the royally appointed court ambassador from Antiva to Orlais. The nobility of Thedas is a rather singular sphere. Those I'm not acquainted with, I know through reputation.
May I ask what brought you to work for the Inquisition?
Sister Leliana approached me. We've been acquainted for quite some time. For better or worse, being the Inquisition's diplomat has become as interesting as she promised.
The Inquisition is lucky to have you as an advocate, Lady Montpellier.
Thank you. Let us hope so. Thedas's politics have become agitated as of late. I hope to guide us down smoother paths. But please excuse me. I've much work to do before the day is done.
We will study that.
You're the Herald. Or, well, the one they're calling the Herald, anyway. I hope the Inquisition can restore order soon. I never really wanted to leave the Circle. My name is Mnave. I research demons and other creatures. Seeker Pentagast and I use what I find to help the soldiers fight them.
I found something the demons left behind. Can you use it?
Yes, that's very helpful. Just leave it there and the Tranquil and I will examine it.
What have your ears heard, Leliana? Anything new we don't already know about?
No, nothing. Let's see what we have.
Work. To work.
At your service. Having the Herald address the clerics is not a terrible idea.
You can't be serious.
Mother Giselle isn't wrong. At the moment, the Chantry's only strength is that they are united in opinion.
And we should ignore the danger to the Herald.
Let's ask him.
You want me to walk into a pit of vipers, and you ask me that?
They're not vipers just because they like to hiss.
I will go with him. Mother Giselle said she could provide us names. Use them.
But why? This is nothing but a...
What choice do we have, Leliana? Right now, we can't approach anyone for help with the breach. Use what influence we have to call the clerics together. Once they are ready, we will see this through. the city still mourns.
Just a guess, Seeker, but I think they all know who we are.
Your skills of observation never fail to impress me, Varric.
My Lord Herald.
You're one of Leliana's people. What have you found?
The Chantry Mothers await you, but so do a great many Templars.
There are Templars here?
People seem to think the Templars will protect them from the Inquisition. They're gathering on the other side of the market. I think that's where the Templars intend to meet you.
Only one thing to do, then. They wish to protect the people? From us?
You think the Order's returned to the fold, maybe? To deal with us upstarts?
I know Lord Seeker Lucius. I can't imagine him coming to the Chantry's defense. Not after all that's occurred.
It just means I have a larger audience to convince.
Perhaps. Return to Haven. Someone will need to inform them if we are... delayed.
As you say, my lady.
Stand wary, guardsman. The Inquisition is here. Along with the Herald of Andrade.
The Templars will stand for us and help Valroyo return to mourning.
It seems that power is alive.
Good people of Valroyo, hear me. Together, we mourn our divine. A naive and beautiful heart, silenced by treachery. You wonder what will become of her murderer. Well, wonder no more. Behold, the so-called Herald of Andraste, claiming to rise where our beloved fell. We say this is a false prophet. The Maker would send no dwarf in our hour of need.
I make no such claim. I wasn't sent here by Andraste or the Maker. I am simply trying to close the breach. It threatens us all.
It's true. The Inquisition seeks only to end this madness before it is too late.
It is already too late. The Templars have returned to the Chantry. They will face this Inquisition, and the people will be safe once more.
Still yourself. She is beneath us.
What's the meaning of this?
Her claim to authority is an insult, much like your own.
Lord Seeker Lucius, it's imperative that we speak with...
You will not address me.
Lord Seeker?
creating a heretical movement. Raising up a puppet as Andraste's prophet, you should be ashamed. You should all be ashamed. The Templars failed no one when they left the Chantry to purge the mages. You are the ones who have failed. You who'd leash our righteous swords with doubt and fear. If you came to appeal to the Chantry, you are too late. The only destiny here that demands respect is mine.
If you're not here to help the Chantry, then you just came to make speeches.
I came to see what frightens old women so, and to laugh.
But Lord Seeker, what if he really was sent by the Maker? What if...
You are called to a higher purpose. Do not question.
I will make the Templar Order a power that stands alone against the Void. We deserve recognition. Independence. You have shown me nothing, and the Inquisition less than nothing. Templars, Val Royo is unworthy of our protection. We march.
Charming fellow, isn't he?
Has Lord Seeker Lucius gone mad?
Do you know him very well?
He took over the Seekers of Truth 2 years ago, after Lord Seeker Lambert's death. He was always a decent man, never given to ambition and grandstanding. This is very bizarre.
Doesn't look like we'll be getting the Templars to help us after all.
I wouldn't write them off so quickly. There must be those in the Order who see what he's become. Either way, we should first return to Haven and inform the others.
Our Templars
rest. Excuse me.
The Chantry promised they'd defend us.
Is what they're saying real? The Inquisition's going to fix the hole in the sky?
I'm going to give it a try, at least.
No one is doing anything. The Chantry's useless, and the Templars... Andraste... I never thought they'd abandon us. Listen. Your camp will need food. I have contacts. We'll have deliveries there in days.
You want to help the Inquisition?
Never been part of something this big before, but... If your Inquisition's going to seal the sky, I want to help.
What do you think, Cassandra?
I think the woman is asking you and not me.
Well, he is...
The Herald of Andraste. Yes, I understand. Haven is a mess, but we won't turn away anyone willing to help. Invite her, if it pleases you.
Head to Haven, then. We need good people.
I don't know if I'm that, but it will be nice to see. Thank you. This victory must please you greatly, Seeker Cassandra.
We came here seeking only to speak with the Mothers. This is not our doing, but yours.
And you had no part in forcing our hand? Do not delude yourself. Now we have been shown up by our own Templars, in front of everyone. And my fellow clerics have scattered to the wind, along with their convictions. Just tell me one thing. If you do not believe you are the Maker's chosen, then what are you?
I'm just a dwarf, in the wrong place at the wrong time.
That is... more comforting than you might imagine. I suppose it is out of our hands now. We shall all see what the Maker plans in the days to come.
How many Templars turned on the Chantry, exactly?
They rebelled across Thedas. Some remained loyal, but not enough to call them the Order. The White Spire here in the capital was the largest garrison, but now it stands empty. Perhaps more shall flock to the Lord Seeker's banner now. How far has faith waned, I wonder?
The Chantry made a big mistake, and now it's paying the price.
Perhaps you are correct. We are only trying to find our way, with little guidance now, but our faith.
That's not enough.
When is it ever enough? That is the nature of faith.
It seems what's that? An arrow with a message?
The Templars didn't even touch you.
My Maker, know my heart. Take from me a life of sorrow. Comfort is only yours to give. Oh, Maker, where is the comfort? Look away. I have broken the chant because it comes from my heart. What have we when our divine is dead and the sky burns?
What do you mean you broke the chant?
Are you also ignorant of the Maker's most basic rites? The chant of light is how we honor the Maker. They are the only words that the faithful should hear from my lips. But I can't. Our divine is dead. Our Templars gone. The Maker's silence is deafening. What hope have we?
The Inquisition can give you the answers you need.
So I have a faith I've lost, or one that seeks to drive it from me. I can't even look to our Templars. How is this not darkness?
The Lord Seeker.
I believe that...
You are the Herald of Andraste, are you not? I have an invitation for you.
If I might have a moment of your time.
Grand Enchanter Fiona?
Leader of the Mage Rebellion. Is it not dangerous for you to be here?
I heard of this gathering, and I wanted to see the fabled Herald of Andraste with my own eyes. If it's help with the breach you seek, perhaps my people are the wiser option.
I'm surprised the leader of the mages wasn't at the conclave.
Yes. You were supposed to be, and yet somehow you avoided death.
As did the Lord Seeker, you'll note. Both of us sent negotiators in our stead in case it was a trap. I won't pretend I'm not glad to live. I lost many dear friends that day. It disgusts me to think the Templars will get away with it. I'm hoping you won't let them.
So you think the Templars are responsible?
Why wouldn't she?
Lucius hardly seems broken up over his losses, if he's concerned about them at all. You heard him. You think he wouldn't happily kill the Divine to turn people against us? So yes, I think he did it. More than I think you did it, at any rate.
And what do you want in exchange for the mage's help?
Oh, I haven't promised the Inquisition our help yet. Consider this an invitation to Redcliffe. Come, meet with the mages. An alliance could help us both, after all. I hope to see you there. Au revoir, my Lord Herald.
Come, let us return to Haven.
Master Kadesh of the Inquisition.
A pleasure, sir. We so rarely have a chance to meet anyone new. It is always the same crowd at these parties. So you must be a guest of Madame de Fer. Or are you here for Duke Bastien?
Are you here on business? I have heard the most curious tales of you. I cannot imagine half of them are true.
What have you heard about me?
Some say that when the veil opened, Andraste herself delivered you from the Fade.
I'm not familiar with that name. I was invited here by First Enchanter Vivienne.
Madame de Fer is a fond nickname the court has given Lady Vivienne.
I've heard she finds it amusing.
I've heard very little about Duke Bastien.
He hasn't been seen much at court lately.
His business with the Council of Heralds often takes him from home for long periods. It can't be good for a man of his years.
And of course, there's the Civil War. Bastien probably wishes to distance himself from the actions of his one-time son-in-law.
Tearing up the Dales in a foolish bid for power? It will end in disgrace for Gaspar. Everyone knows it.
I don't care what they say about me.
You should. The game has crushed far more powerful institutions than your Inquisition.
The Inquisition. What a lot of pig shit. Washed up sisters and crazed seekers. No one can take them seriously. Everyone knows it's just an excuse for a bunch of political outcasts to grab power.
I've never made any claims to holiness. What's your point?
In front of all these people, you admit to being a pretentious usurper. We know what your Inquisition truly is. If you were a man of honor, you'd step outside and answer the charges.
My dear Marquis, how unkind of you to use such language in my house to my guests. You know such rudeness is intolerable.
Madame Vivienne, I humbly beg your pardon.
You should. Whatever am I going to do with you, my dear? My lord, you're the wounded party in this unfortunate affair. What would you have me do with this foolish, foolish man?
He insulted my honor. I want him dead.
And this, Marquis, is why one must always be courteous to one's fellow guests. Someone be a dear and clean this mess up. We can't have him cluttering up the dance floor. I'm delighted you could attend this little gathering. I've so wanted to meet you. Allow me to introduce myself. I am Vivienne, First Enchanter of Montsimard and Enchantress to the Imperial Court.
Can you get away with killing a nobleman like that?
He attempted to draw his weapon, unprovoked, in the presence of witnesses. Duels are not fought in the drawing room. By Chevalier code, his life was forfeit from the moment his hand fell to his hilt.
Your salon has certainly exceeded my expectations so far.
I'm glad to keep you entertained, my dear. I wanted to meet face to face. It is important to consider one's connections carefully. With Divine Justinia dead, the Chantry's in shambles. Only the Inquisition might restore sanity and order to our frightened people. As the leader of the last loyal mages of Thedas, I feel it only right that I lend my assistance to your cause.
Is your interest in the Inquisition, Madame de Fer, or is it more personal?
Aren't you charming? It's professional, of course.
The Inquisition will be happy to have you, Lady Vivienne.
Great things are beginning, my dear. I can promise you that.
Come on, you've seen our mounts. Most of them should be pulling plows.
Didn't all grow up fancy noble?
might be more useful here.
We'll see.
You're kind of a force of nature, aren't you?
When I need to be.
It's impressive.
You flatter me.
Trying.
Did I do the right thing? What I have set in motion here could destroy everything I have revered my whole life. One day they may write about me as a traitor, a madwoman, a fool, and they may be right.
What does your faith tell you?
I believe you are innocent. I believe more is going on here than we can see. And I believe no one else cares to do anything about it. They will stand in the fire and complain that it is hot. But is this the Maker's will? I can only guess.
What's going to happen now?
Now we find allies to help us close the breach, if that is even possible. And if there are consequences to be paid for what I have done, I pay them. I only pray the price is not too high.
You didn't have any choice.
Didn't I? My trainers always said, Cassandra, you are too brash. You must think before you act. I see what must be done, and I do it. I see no point in running around in circles like a dog chasing its tail. But I misjudged you in the beginning, did I not? I thought the answer was before me, clear as day. I cannot afford to be so careless again.
Can't say I'm not grateful to hear that.
I can be harsh, I know. You've said you don't believe you're chosen. Does that mean you also don't believe in the Maker?
You're asking a dwarf?
You're a surface dwarf. I've known some, like Varric, who, I suppose, it doesn't matter now. I have to believe we were put on this path for a reason, even if you do not. Now it simply remains to see where it leads us.
You there. There's a shield in your hand. Block with it. If this man were your enemy, you'd be dead. Lieutenant, don't hold back. The recruits must prepare for a real fight, not a practice one.
Yes, Commander.
We've received a number of recruits. Locals from Haven and some pilgrims. None made quite the entrance you did.
That wasn't my idea.
I'd be concerned if it was. I was recruited to the Inquisition in Kirkhall myself. I was there during the Mage Uprising. I saw firsthand the devastation it caused.
Sir.
Cassandra sought a solution. When she offered me a position, I left the Templars to join her cause. Now it seems we face something far worse.
You left the Templars for this? You believe the Inquisition can work?
I do. The Chantry lost control of both Templars and Mages. Now they argue over a new divine while the breach remains. The Inquisition could act when the Chantry cannot. Our followers would be part of that. There's so much we can...
Forgive me. I doubt you came here for a lecture.
You've given this a lot of thought.
I know what happens when order is lost, and action comes too late. There's still a lot of work ahead.
Commander, Sir Raiden has a report on our supply lines.
As I was saying.
is in Lisette. We cannot stay here.
Why not?
Because we're Templars.
What does that even mean anymore? Still got demons pouring out of the rifts. Delivering children and helping old men through the winter cough. Seeing these injuries. I was with the Templars. I can tend any wound caused by blade or a mage's fire. I'll admit that demons are new, though.
It's good you've returned. We heard of your encounter.
You heard?
My agents in a city sent word ahead, of course.
It's a shame the Templars have abandoned their senses as well as the capital.
At least we know the Chantry is no longer a threat to us.
Yes, and we have the opening we need to approach the Templars and the mages.
Do we? Lord Seeker Lucius is not the man I remember.
True, he has taken the order somewhere, but to do what? My reports have been very odd.
We must look into it. I'm certain not everyone in the order will support the Lord Seeker.
Or the Herald could simply go to meet the mages in Redcliffe instead.
You think the Mage Rebellion is more united? It could be 10 times worse.
Or you could stop bickering and make a decision.
I agree.
We shouldn't discount Redcliffe. The mages may be worth the risk.
They are powerful, Ambassador, but more desperate than you realize.
So it'll be dangerous. I've been in danger since I walked out of the Fade.
If some among the rebel mages were responsible for what happened at the Conclave,
the same could be said about the Templars.
True enough. Right now, I'm not certain we have enough influence to approach the Order safely.
Then the Inquisition needs agents in more places. That's something you can help with.
In the meantime, we should consider other options. There is one other matter. Several months ago, the Grey Wardens of Ferelden vanished. I sent word to those in Orlais, but they have also disappeared. Ordinarily, I wouldn't even consider the idea they're involved in all this, but the timing is curious.
So you're telling me this because...
The others have disregarded my suspicion, but I cannot ignore it. 2 days ago, my agents in the Hinterlands heard news of a Grey Warden by the name of Blackwall. If you have the opportunity, please seek him out. Perhaps he can put my mind at ease.
And if he can't?
Then there may be more going on than we thought.
Nothing to do with fairness. We simply can't accommodate them if they bring that many servants.
I will speak to the Duchess. She can be reasoned with, after a fashion. Let's see what we have.
That can't be it. Perhaps Leliana was... No, that seems unlikely. What can... Oh, hello, Master Kadash.
Something on your mind, Ambassador?
You could say that. I was speaking with Leliana and... Well, we discussed how to make people understand that a dwarf could be a herald of Andraste.
Tell them stranger things have happened. The Maker moves in mysterious ways and all that.
Yes, he certainly does. Leliana was telling me rumors that... It sounds preposterous, but... There are stories circulating that you were part of a criminal organization. The Dwarven Garda.
I used to be. The Carter doesn't like their own to get too famous.
So it's true. Oh my. Were you only smuggling at least? Exchanging a few goods on the surface?
I guarded caravans of smuggled goods. Rivals often ambushed us. There were protection rackets, blood feuds, targeted...
That's quite enough. I have a clear picture. I'll handle the subject of your past carefully, Herald. I'm sure you can't miss that life.
Why wouldn't I? I was the best at what I did. My old bosses are probably tearing their hair out trying to replace me.
I will take your word for it, so long as they won't be able to win you back. That sort of competition is the last thing we require.
You've brought back some fascinating things. We're putting them to good use.
You said Cassandra has you researching creatures.
Yes. If you find anything interesting in your travels, I'd appreciate you bringing it to me. I may be able to find some weakness our soldiers can exploit when fighting various creatures. At the least, some materials are useful for making potions or gear for the Inquisition.
I'll speak with you later.
Thank you again for what you've brought back. If you find anything, please bring it in.
granted them power over the very Fade itself.
I met an elven mage earlier. Solus, I believe he was called. I admit I was surprised. I didn't expect to find mages among the Inquisition. Tell me, why were you at the Divine Conclave?
The war benefits no one. It must end, and order must be restored.
If only the rebels saw things so clearly. Justinia's death has shattered the balance of power in Thedas. If it is not restored quickly, countless lives will be lost. Mages, Templars, innocent people of all kinds now look to the Inquisition to decide their fate.
I'll try not to let them down.
Failure is a luxury we cannot afford, my dear. For almost 1,000 years, the world believed it was in the hands of the Maker. And now many believe you are the agent of his will. Whatever the truth is, that belief gives you power.
Nobody should claim to know the will of the Maker. Not me, and not the Chantry.
Perhaps nobody should. But if no one leads the way, many will be left behind in darkness. I've stolen enough of your time, my dear. Don't let me keep you.
Excuse me. I've got a message for the Inquisition, but I'm having a hard time getting anyone to talk to me.
Who are you, soldier?
Crimisius Aclasi with the Bull's Charges Mercenary Company. We mostly work out of Orle and Navarra. We've got word of some Tevinter mercenaries gathering out on the Storm Coast. My company commander, Iron Bull, offers the information free of charge. If you'd like to see what the Bull's Charges can do for the Inquisition, meet us there and watch us work.
What can your Bull's Chargers offer the Inquisition?
We're loyal, we're tough, and we don't break contracts. Ask around Val Royeau. We've got references.
What should I know about your commander?
Iron Bull. He's one of those Canari, the big guys with the horns. He leads from the front. He pays well, and he's a lot smarter than the last bastard I worked for. Best of all, he's professional. We accept contracts with whoever makes the first real offer. You're the first time he's gone out of his way to pick a side.
Why did your commander send us this information?
Iron Bull wants to work for the Inquisition. Thinks you're doing good work.
I look forward to meeting this Iron Bull.
We're the best you'll find. Come to the Storm Coast and you can see us in action.
Saying something about Cullen?
Yes. Haven has limited space for our soldiers to train. Perhaps we could set up something over here.
Let us begin.
Your Worship, for what it's worth, welcome to the Storm Coast. I would have sent word sooner, but our efforts have been delayed.
How so?
There's a group of bandits operating in the area. They know the terrain, and our small party has had trouble going up against them. Some of our soldiers went to speak with their leader. Haven't heard back, though.
Of course you haven't.
The soldiers didn't have an exact location for the bandits, but they were starting their search farther down the beach. With all this fuss, we haven't been able to conduct a proper search for the wardens either. Well, good luck, and enjoy the sea air. I hear it's good for the soul.
How'd we do?
5 or 6 wounded, Chief. No dead.
That's what I like to hear. Let the throat cutters finish up, then break out the casks. So, you're with the Inquisition, huh? Glad you could make it. Come on, have a seat. Drinks are coming.
Iron Bull, I presume.
Yeah, the horns usually give it away. I assume you remember Kremisius Aklasi, my lieutenant.
Good to see you again. Throat cutters are done, Chief.
Already? Have them check again. I don't want any of those Tevinter bastards getting away. No offense, Krem.
None taken. At least a bastard knows who his mother was. Puts him one up on you, Canari, right?
So, you've seen us fight. We're expensive, but we're worth it. And I'm sure the Inquisition can afford us.
How much is this going to cost me, exactly?
Wouldn't cost you anything personally. Unless you want to buy drinks later. Your ambassador, what's her name? Josephine. We'd go through her and get the payment set up. Gold will take care of itself. Don't worry about that. All that matters is we're worth it.
The Chargers seem like an excellent company.
They are, but you're not just getting the boys. You're getting me. You need a frontline bodyguard. I'm your man. Whatever it is. Demons? Dragons? The bigger the better. And there's one other thing. Might be useful. Might piss you off. Ever hear of the Ben Hasra?
They're a Canari organization, right? The equivalent of their guards and city watch.
I'd go closer to spies. But yeah, that's them. Or, well, us. The Ben Hasrath are concerned about the breach. Magic out of control like that could cause trouble everywhere. I've been ordered to join the Inquisition, get close to the people in charge, and send reports on what's happening. But I also get reports from Ben Hasrath agents all over Orlais. You sign me on, I'll share them with your people.
You're a Canary spy, and you just told me?
Whatever happened at that conclave thing, it's bad. Someone needs to get that breach closed. So whatever I am, I'm on your side.
You still could have hidden what you are.
From something called the Inquisition? I'd have been tipped sooner or later. Better you hear it right up front from me.
What would you send home in these reports of yours?
Enough to keep my superiors happy. Nothing that'll compromise your operations. The Canary want to know if they need to launch an invasion to stop the whole damn world from falling apart. You let me send word of what you're doing, it'll put some minds at ease. That's good for everyone.
What's in these Ben Hasrath reports you're offering to share?
Enemy movements, suspicious activity, intriguing gossip. It's a bit of everything. Alone, they're not much, but if your spy master is worth a damn, she'll put him to good use.
She?
I did a little research. Plus, I've always had a weakness for redheads.
All right, you're in.
Excellent. Prem, tell the men to finish drinking on the road. The Chargers just got hired.
What about the casks, Chief? We just opened them up with axes.
Find some way to seal them. You're Tervinter, right? Try blood magic. We'll meet you back at Haven.